In this lesson, we'll be starting the build of the sample file I've designed for this course. I'll be showing you how to resize columns and rows and explaining the difference between worksheets and workbooks in Excel. By default, in a blank workbook, the rows are all the same size and the columns are all the same size, but they can be changed in a few different ways. With the click and drag method, you can just hover your mouse between two columns at the top and you'll see that it changes to like a double arrow icon. Just click, hold and drag it to the right and the column itself will get bigger. That also works on the rows, so again, you're looking for this double arrow icon. You click on it, you drag it down, your row will get bigger. With the auto fit method, Excel will do its best to size the column to fit the data that you've got in it. So for example here, we can see that column D is actually way bigger than it needs to be in terms of width. If I double click, again, I'm looking for this double arrow icon at the top. And this time I'm going to double click it, as I said, and that's then shrunk the column to fit Excel Goat Course 1. If I then delete that out and then double click it again, it's going to shrink it to fit the word Excel. If I then put Excel Goat Course 1 back and double click again, it then grows the column again to fit as best it can to the data you've got in the full column. By right-click on the column label section from any of the columns, you'll see that a menu appears. By then click column width from that menu, you'll see that a number comes up which represents the width of that column. If I change that, so in this case let's change it to 100 and press enter or click OK, it will then change the column to 100 wide. This method also works for rows, so if I right-click anywhere on the row labels section, you'll see a menu comes up and this time we're going to choose row height. Again, we're going to change it to 100 and press enter. And you'll see that the row has grown to 100. Don't worry too much about the unit of measure that Excel uses where I've set things to 100 or 50. It's not millimeters, it's not centimeters, and really it's not important what it is. The important thing to take away is if you set something to 100, it'll be twice the size of something that's 50, and it'll be exactly the same size as every other row that you set to 50 as well. We can change the size of multiple rows at one time. So for example, if I click and drag on row 1 all the way down to row 27, and then right click in the row label section, again click on row height, we're going to set it back to the default value for Excel, which I know to be 15. Hit 15, press enter, it's back to default. We're about to start building the sample file now, so open yourself a blank workbook and the first thing you want to do is hit save at the top left and then call it something useful. So I'm going to call it course 1 sample. I'm just going to take the default and save it into my documents area. Hit save, done. For the workbook we'll be making in this course, we're going to set the row height of row 1 to 63. So right click on it, click row height, type 63 and press enter. We'll also be changing the column width of column A to 33. So right click on column A, click column width, type 33, press enter. I'm going to explain why we've done that later on in the course. At the top of my screen there's 29 visible columns. There's a few things that can increase or reduce that number, and that can make things look different on your screen. I wanted to give you a heads up about it, as what we could build will end up looking slightly different on your screen as a result, and I don't want that to be a worry or a distraction, as it doesn't change the fundamentals of what I'm going to show you. Anyway, here's three of the things that can impact it. I'm using a full HD screen, which is pretty standard in 2021 for laptops and monitors. If you've got a lower resolution screen, you'll see fewer columns at the top when you first open Excel. Conversely, if you've got a higher resolution screen, maybe a 4K for example, then you'll have more columns. It's as simple as that. Down the bottom right, you'll see a zoom setting. Mine's currently set to 100% and I'd advise you to choose this setting for all of your workbooks and across all worksheets to maintain consistency throughout your design. Probably a good time for me to bring some clarity to what a workbook and a worksheet are in Excel. Down the bottom left, you'll see this little tab thing that's labeled Sheet 1. The plus sign to the right of that adds new tabs, which it will sequentially number, so you can see it's called this one Sheet 2. If I click it again, we've got Sheet 3. The file that holds all of these worksheets is called a workbook, and that's the thing that you save. As a demonstration, I've put the word example in cell A1 on sheet 1, 2, and 3. I've also set the zoom size differently on each of those sheets. So sheet 1 has a zoom size of 100%, as you can see down this bottom right-hand corner. Sheet 2 has got 200%, and you'll see how the word example is twice the size. Yet the font size is still the same at 11. If we go to sheet 3, we can see again that the font size is still set to 11, and yet the word has got bigger because I've set the zoom size to 300%. Trust me, this can get really confusing as you go forward, so my suggestion to you is just set everything to 100% and it will make things a lot easier. What this also demonstrates really well is how the zoom setting can affect the number of visible columns at the top. On sheet 3, we've set it to 300% as I explained, and we can see at the top, we've only got 9 visible columns now instead of the 29 that we had earlier. The third thing that can affect how many columns are visible at the top is something I mentioned before, column widths. Obviously, if you've made your columns bigger, less of them will fit at the top of your screen. You might be asking at this point, why does any of this stuff matter? The answer in truth is it doesn't really, for the most part, but if you're building this file as you follow the course along and you find that you've got a different number of columns at the top to what I'm showing you, you'll also find that the overall design is displayed slightly differently to what it is on my screen. Any of the things we've talked about could be why, and I don't want that to be confusing. In the next lesson, we'll be building further on our sample file, and I'll be showing you how to bring some color and pictures to a workbook to improve its overall look and layout. Then we'll be taking a look at how we can use the design of popular websites like YouTube as inspiration to improve the general usability of the tools we create.